Deep in the deserts of the Middle East, insurgents blow up a gas station. Snipers hit their target. This is actually a training range in Jordan. 1,200 Special Forces troops from the U.S. and more than a dozen countries are practicing the most dangerous missions. One scenario, a hijacked jetliner sits on the airfield. This is some of the most realistic training that U.S. Special Operations Forces are getting here in the Middle East. An Airbus 300 hijacked. They will come on board and rescue the hostages. More training assaulting terrorist safe houses. This is the kind of training that Navy SEAL team got before they assaulted Osama bin Laden's compound. Coming up a dark staircase, not knowing what's waiting for them at the top. As the U.S. and its Middle East allies consider whether to take possible action against the Syrian regime and even against Iran's nuclear program, their commando forces are working together like never before. Navy SEAL Todd Tinsley runs a team out of the Persian Gulf. The basics, he says, remain unchanged.
Shoot, move, and communicate. And that's what SOF is very good at.
There are new partners here, like Iraq, which is providing this overhead imagery.
You get in, you do your job, and you get out without anybody knowing about it. And if you can do that with your partner force, and they are able to do that, that is success.
Even after the wars in Iraq and Afghanistan, the future of U.S. Special Forces lies in their ability to do whatever it takes. Admiral William McRaven heads all U.S. Special Operations.
If this is where things really go bad, what we want to be able to do is engage with the host nation very early on, begin to build up their capability and allow them to deal with the problem so we don't get to the point where it goes boom.
So, you hear an awful lot about those drone attacks, right, Wolf? The secret drone attacks over Yemen, Somalia, Pakistan, all of these places. Sure, there is a lot of emphasis on those unmanned attacks, those drones. But what we saw on the ground in the Middle East is troops from various nations working together because they truly believe the next time they have to go and do some contingency, the next time they bluntly go to war, they will go together. But if not together, U.S. forces are prepared, as always, they say, to go it alone. Wolf?
Certainly are. All right, Barbara, thank you. Barbara, just back from...